Hello, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube. My name is Brad. This is my channel, Animate Orange, where I built a lot of 3D metal models and show you how I do it. Today, back on the table, the next installment of the Freight Train Build, we have the little short hopper car. We're almost all done. And as I said at the end of the boxcar video, this looks very similar. It looks like it's going to be a very similar build. So let's open this back up and get to it and continue with the Freight Train Build. I'm going to make a bit of an assumption here, like I have in the past couple of videos. I'm going to assume that you've built some of these Metal Marth models before, probably watched some of my videos before, and have some idea of what the instructions and assembly flowchart are about, how they work, the symbols and codes and whatnot used in them. Or at least you've been following this series from the very beginning, since the build of the locomotive, and you have an idea. If not, do some, you know, I suggest going back watching the previous videos, watching some other Metal Earth build videos before starting on this. This is not a hard kit, but a little bit more advanced. Not terribly so. So I'm going to make those assumptions and not spend a lot of time talking about the directions. What I am going to talk about is, for this build, we're starting on page 5 of the boxcar and hopper car build instructions. And I'm going to talk a little bit about some tools. Let's take a moment to talk about the tools that I use. This is my standard set that I use in most every build. I have long needle nose pliers and flat nose pliers, useful for a variety of different things. I have flush clippers that I use to cut the parts off the trees. It makes it quick and easy. And then I have some precision tweezers, one with a very pointed end, one that's had the pointed end ground down slightly, and one with a flat, sort of curved end. Great for getting into curved areas. And then I have a standard set of tweezers with an angled tip. These come in one of the Iconics models, and I love them and use them a lot. When it comes to shaping rounded parts, there are many options. I used dowel rods for a long time. I sharpened the ends of two of them with a pencil sharpener. These two are great for making cone shapes. Another option is a cheap drill bit set. The set has quite a few different sizes to choose from. Another option is a set of step mandrels. So I've talked a little bit about tools. I've got some basics to get me started. I've got the what's remaining of the two sheets here to build this part of the assembly instructions to build the hopper car. Let's get started. If you've been following along with the previous Freight Train video, you're probably noticing a pattern by this point. As in the last two builds, I'm doing the wheel sets together. I'm using the same small drill bit and flat nose pliers to curve and shape the little axles. A couple of times I had to pinch the ends of the tabs in a little bit to line them up with their slots better.
and now to shape all 8 wheels. And this time, I remember which tool worked best to shape them. Bear in mind as you're watching this video that it is edited, and I have clipped out a lot of boring and repetitive parts, and sometimes sections where I've had to make multiple tries and adjustments to get a part to fit. That may make it look like this build comes together a little easier than it actually did. So keep that in mind when you're doing your own build. Take your time and be patient. It may take several tries and adjustments to get things to fit. Here's that odd-shaped Part 7 piece again. It's the same piece from the boxcar that I tried using the round nose pliers to shape. I was not satisfied with the outcome, so this time I tried bending up the ends, using them as a guideline to shape it. I used my ground-down pointed tweezers to bend a little at a time, working my way out. It turned out a little better, but still not completely satisfied. However, I don't think I personally could have done much better. It's just an odd one to shape. Thank you. bottom of the hopper car is a very similar support structure as to the box car, and for whatever reason this time, I had a little more trouble getting all the little slots lined up. You may have noticed that I missed part 25. I was interrupted during the build right before getting to that part. When I came back, I started with the next section. I'll figure out here in just a little bit that I missed it towards the end and add it in. Like before, to shape the hook, I bend the first bend and then use the shape of the one side of the hook as a guideline to carefully bend a little at a time, the little strip that sticks out, to bend it into shape. And then after folding in the other half of the hook, I push the tail end piece in just a little bit with the tip of the tweezers. I had trouble getting the wheel assemblies attached. I did not quite bend the angles of the sides correctly. I had to adjust them. These tabs were angled out and didn't line up. Take note that these ladders have what looks like little rivet details on one side. This is the engraved side and should face out. Be sure to bend the tabs so that the engraved side does face out. Again, there is a tip to bend one of the tabs up and one tab down to hold the side pieces. Good advice, one tab up will keep the side from sagging down, and with the other tab bent down, it will keep it from sagging inward. However, I'm going to do my own trick and lightly twist the tabs. That will be easier to do than trying to bend them right now, and then later, when all the sides are together and the structure is secure, there'll be enough support that I can just bend them all up in the same direction, making for a neat look. As I was looking for part 30, I am thinking about how I am almost finished with the hopper and there are very few parts left, and then one of them stood out. Part 25. I realized I'd missed something. Fortunately, it's not too late and I was able to easily take the sides back off, add part 25, and then continue. Now to bend over those twisted tabs.
And it's done. Finished and complete. And like I said in the beginning, this is probably going to be a lot like the boxcar build. And it was. The bottom of it was almost completely identical. You had the wheels were the same. The end piece was the same. You have a very similar framework, slightly different size. You have that weird piece that's difficult to shape that I had a little bit better luck with this time, but not much. A couple other pieces. And then the top comes together very similarly. It's very much the same build, and I guess maybe with a little practice, this one only took me an hour. I shaved off 15 minutes from my build. Pretty quick and simple and easy. I'm enjoying this build so far, and I'm one more left to go. I think probably the caboose may be a little bit more complicated, but I'm not worried about it. Not worried at all. I'll leave it at that. Time to go finish the last model. If you have any questions or comments, as always, leave them down below. If you enjoy these videos, you want to help support this channel, I would appreciate it. It's not necessary, but I'd appreciate it. It'd help bring more interesting and larger builds. Check out my Patreon link at the description down below and at the end of this video. As always, thank you for watching and keep on keeping on.